Alright guys, NMRC back with you guys. Told you guys I was going to put STX6 axles on a 10th scale rig. These are 10th scale frame rails with the stock shock hoops from that 6 bolted onto here. These are the GPM STX6 shocks. Had to put new internals and bearings in there. That's the stock servo. So I was able to get a punch and punch that pin out of the servo main gear drive that the horn connects to. If you guys are following along, you'll know what I'm talking about. I was able to pop that pin out, drill a new hole, and hammer that pin into the new hole, and that damn servo works now. So yeah, anytime you strip a STX6 servo out, take it apart, you'll see what I'm saying. All you do is you take that main shaft and gear out that's to the servo horn. It'll have a pin. It's a stopper to limit how far your horn swings. All you do is pop that pin out, drill a hole on the opposite side of that pin, put that pin in, put it back in, boom, your servo is working again. Don't have to buy another damn servo. Now my boy Jerome, I can't pronounce his last name, JCD on Facebook, man. Hit him up, man. I'll try and tag him in this video too, a picture of a screenshot of his name on Facebook. He did all the 3D printing for me. He did the servo mount, the skid for me, and the rear brace. We're gonna brace the top of the shock posts. Only issue, and these are STX6 metal drive shafts from Yaw Racing or something like that. Everything's off eBay other than the 3D printed shit and the stock stuff. Shocks, eBay. I think like $80 for all four or something. I can't remember. The links are like 40 some bucks, which I had to buy another set of these black one piece links. No plastic rod ends. They're all aluminum because I broke my panhard on my 6 over here. At the top, and yes, I have aluminum shock hoop, so it's a stupid plastic rod end broke, so I bought those to be putting those on it. The only issue, I did test it, which you're gonna see in this video, a little run over a tree stump. This motor is the Fusion 1800 KV. This is a TGH 2 low comp transmission with 30% overdrive automatically in it for the front. This is a 64 tooth spur with a 11 tooth pinion. That's the smallest pinion I have. I need to drop it down to a 9 pinion and probably up this spur because this motor's getting hot. It's getting too hot. I had a 15 pinion with this spur, and it was getting really, really, really hot where I couldn't even touch it, hold it. Now it's not so bad, but it's still, you know, the more you run it, the hotter it's gonna get, you know what I'm saying? So that's all I gotta do is figure out the ratio, because these axles, you know, aren't meant for a 10th scale transmission, right? So they're over geared. This thing has stupid, crazy wheel speed. It's fucking fast, man. But anyway, you know, all the haters on Facebook, eat your heart out. I'm going to be posting that on here. I appreciate everybody here on my YouTube. They all have respect for the most part and, you know, want to see it. That's what RC is all about. So to prove to you, here's, I mean, you can't tell me those are 2.2s. Those are SCX stock wheels right there off of that SCX6. And then here's the axles right here. The, what do they call them, the AR90s or whatever? See that big old trill diff cover right there? See that beauty? Yeah, you know what I mean? Big old beefy ass links. These are the black links I told you I bought another set of for my SCX6. They're 8-piece. The only thing they don't come with is your steering links. Comes with the upper and lower, rear, front, and your Panhard. So they're only like 40 some bucks on eBay. Look them up. Just look up links, SCX6 links, and you'll see them. All aluminum. They're from China and all that. But trust me, they're good. I just test run them. They did pretty damn good. I bought, like I said, these drive shafts are nice. They're all steel, the whole thing. They're not plastic. So I'll probably get these again and put them on my SCX6. Yes, I know they made a carbon frame rails for the SCX6, which I might have to do and put the SCX6 transmission by another one and put it in this setup to make a comp one, because I'd like a big comp rig too. But yeah, there it is right there, guys. That way you can better see it. JCD Customs 3D Printing. He made that skid. He even did the back brace pretty dope too. Watch, let me flip this over. It says SCX6 2.0 second version. So I told you guys I'll do it. I did it. It's done. I extended the frame. So yes, this is C channel from Home Depot, because I wanted to use these stock beefy links, and the there's just no way that you cannot not extend this. You have to extend it, because then your axles will be, your frame will be here, right? This end here will be here. Your axles weigh the F out here. You know what I mean? And then to get the right shock angle and all that, you have to extend the frame rails. That's just all there is to it. It's 18-inch wheelbase. You know, it's different. But we got to figure out the gearing. I'll keep you guys posted on if I get that figured out, and more run video probably tomorrow. See how hot this gets. I may have to throw a castle system, that H-scale censored ESC and motor in this to handle it with this tranny. I don't know. That's the only other thing I could think of, other than, you know, having to put an SCX transmission and motor in this damn thing, which I don't want to make it 2-speed. I want it single drive like it is now. But anyway, there's that, and I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you on the next video.